All right, guys, we're gonna do a foam roll and stretch circuit here, okay? So I'm gonna count you guys down for 1 minute for each of the foam roll exercises, and then we're gonna hold stretches for 20 seconds. Okay, so just listen for my cueing, and I'll talk you guys through the timing on this one. Okay, John's got his foam roll. We're gonna start with the piriformis. Let's start with the right side. So he's gonna cross his right leg over his left leg, rotate down to his right, and we're rolling back and forth. All right, guys, let's go. Clock has started. So by really pulling your leg up to your opposite shoulder, you're gonna stretch that piriformis out, and you wanna roll the piriformis, any muscle for that matter, in a stretched out position, so we're getting all the fibers. If you find a spot that's really sticky and painful, I want you to just hang out right there, take some nice deep breaths. Try to get that muscle knot to resolve, get it to relax. We've got 20 seconds left, guys. 15 seconds left. Okay, so we are going, that's it right there. Okay, we're gonna stretch that muscle out now that we just foam rolled it. So we're gonna be on the back, cross the right leg over the left leg, grab onto the back of the knee, and really using that right elbow to push out. Okay, hold it. That's fine. Actually, guys, I'd prefer you put the hands behind the knees. If you put it on top of the knees, you're compressing the knee joint. So yeah, it's a little bit safer to hold on behind the knees. Okay, so really pressing that right elbow out onto the knee. Roll your tailbone down to my hand right there, good. Feel that yet? A little bit? Yeah. John's pretty flexible, guys. Okay, that'll do it, guys. Come on up, let's get the left side. So I know when we're in class, all right, 1 minute starts now. So when we're in class, I know we roll the right side to the left side and then stretch it out. Ideally, if you have the ability to do it, it's best to do foam roll and stretch immediately afterwards. It's just more efficient, it's more effective stretch. So that's how we're gonna do it here today. So you're gonna adjust your positioning on that hip as you need to feel that better. Fifteen seconds left, guys. Three, two, one, and he's off, and we're stretching the left piriformis. Right, left leg over right leg, there we go. Grabbing on behind the knee, pressing out with his left hand. Really rolling the tailbone down to the grass, leaving your legs right where they are. For the sake of the film, we're just holding this stretch one time. Again, if you have time to do it on your own, it'd be great if you could do two stretches after the foam roll. Okay, come on up. All right, guys, next we're doing the IT band. I know you guys are doing this on your own, but let's knock it out right now. John's starting on his right side. Okay, 1 minute starts now. All right, so lateral part of the leg all the way down to the knee. As he rolls up and closer to the hip, he's gonna roll forward toward me, more to the anterior part of the hip. That's gonna get the TFL muscle, which is the small muscle that becomes the IT band. You'll know it when you're on it. Looks good. Halfway there. Ten seconds left. Okay, so I want you lying on your right side facing the camera. All right, guys, now we're gonna stretch out that IT band. Tough area to stretch. Let me show you one option. I know you guys all have options on your own, at the wall and stuff like that. All right, so a few components here. You're gonna start with your knee and hip in front of the body. What you're gonna do is lift your leg way up in the air, keep this hip forward, and then bring the knee back this way. Okay, now you're just gonna kinda let your leg fall down, let gravity pull it up. John's gonna take his right leg up, put his heel on top of his quad, and then just apply a little bit of weight down this way. Okay, so the idea here is to keep this pelvis, put your hand behind your head, good. Keep this pelvis up this way. If this IT band is tight, it's gonna pull the pelvis down this way. So again, John looks pretty loose, but the components of that stretch are very important to come bring your leg from in front, up and over, and then back before you apply the opposite leg as weight. Okay, looks good. Let's get the left side. Again, 1 minute with the foam roll. Left side. 1 minute starts now, guys. So John's gonna roll to the front of his hip right there, good. Fun fact, an asteroid is gonna nearly miss crashing into the Earth on Friday. If you don't read the newspapers. Do you see that? I think they just discovered it about 13 months ago. It's big. It's big. I think I read somewhere that it would cause about, the impact would be about 20 times the amount of the atomic bomb. Ten seconds left. Close enough that it could take out some satellites, though. Okay, on to your right side, again facing the camera. Your IT band stretch, other side. All right guys, let's review this one more time here. So, top knee comes forward, lift the knee way up, take it up and over, make sure the hip stays forward here. Okay, and then he's gonna bring his opposite leg up, apply the heel down, and make sure this hip stays up here. Okay, so again, nice extensibility here with John. You guys may not be able to bring that knee down. And because we're really stretching the IT band, which is a real fibrous tissue, you're not gonna feel a stretch as you normally would with like a hamstring, for instance. It's just because they don't have stretch receptors in that IT band. Trust me, it's stretching. Okay, go ahead and unwind, guys. Last foam roll for this session, we're gonna do the thoracic spine. So John's gonna lie on his back, cross the arms over his chest, chin tucks down toward the throat, so make sure you're in a nice streamlined position. 1 minute starts right now, guys. Great exercise to do, especially before and after big swim sets. Fifteen seconds, guys. Okay, looks good. So we're gonna stretch that out now. So we're gonna be down in a child's pose or prayer stretch. Ideally, if you guys could find something to anchor yourself onto, I will be John's anchor here. He's gonna grab onto the stick. And so from here, he's really pulling the shoulders down his back towards his back pockets. So he's just kind of using counterbalance from a stable object here, trying to get some release in through his shoulder blades, through those muscles of the thoracic spine. All right, so each breath you take takes you down a little bit deeper into that stretch. Should not be any pain at the top of the shoulders with this. Okay, and slowly go ahead and relax. Okay, guys, that's the foam roll and stretch portion. Get it done.